According to the Health Ministry, the government will soon retable the National Health Insurance Bill in Parliament to pave way for the National Health Scheme. Speaking during the 7th National Community Health Financing Conference that ended today in Entebbe, the Minister of State for Primary Health Care, Margaret Muhanga, asked Ugandans to embrace it.
The good news is that the health insurance bill will come. The president just sent it back with issues to change. We have changed. I was actually reading it this morning. I woke up at 4 to read the changes and read the entire treatment.
However, Frederick Makaire, the chief executive officer of Save for Health, a private community health insurance scheme, said the government should onboard private and community insurance schemes when rolling out the national one.
First of all, it's important to note that in the bill of 2021 that had been passed by Parliament, the community insurance schemes had been recognized to exist. Their role had not been defined. But in these discussions, we have been engaging the framers, the ministry and Parliament, to make sure that the roles are actually explicitly indicated, included in the bill. And one of the roles we are looking at that the community insurance schemes can play is the role of what we call mobilizing the communities in the informal sector. Secondly, the role of distribution. These community insurance schemes have structures on the ground, right to village level. So they are able to use those structures to collect premiums, and then with the national insurance cards are out, the schemes can actually go distributing these cards to the families.
Regulate health insurance across the country and avert financial risks that arise from high out-of-pocket expenditure on sickness, disability and others.
First introduced in Parliament 15 years ago, the health insurance bill was in 2021 passed by MPs but rejected by the president for unknown reasons.
We always talk about healthcare as if it's only about the bill you pay when you are being discharged. But there are costs related to transport, there are costs related to staying in the hospital, feeding and all those things. So those other costs actually are still a barrier to access. So the scheme, the community insurance schemes can actually go and cover people for those costs.
Policymakers and other stakeholders, however, want the bill fast-tracked for Uganda to achieve universal health access. Dr. Rutahigwa Elisa, the Rukunjiri Municipality MP, said the bill should be passed now to save MPs from footing hefty medical bills of their constituencies.
When we talked with our minister, we asked them, where is the bill? We are told it is somewhere in cabinet, you know, but for us, we are waiting. People went to the bush and fought for 5 years and came out of the bush. So how can we fight with this bill for 15 years and above? I mean, when we are fighting from this kind of environment, that we cannot succeed, no.
Report compiled by Sam Wakaka for the news.